What's up, everybody? It's the Mixed Truck here, and I'm back with more NBA. And looking at this schedule, I'm starting to see a fucking pattern take place. You know, it looks like I'm gonna lose and win all year. But no, that's not what's gonna happen. I decided to record a game that I'm gonna actually win. So hopefully I actually win so I can post this. So, yeah, I don't know what else, so, without review, oh wait, I have some trades, I'll throw them up on the screen. I made trades and stuff, and those are it, so, okay, without further ado, let's get into this. Alright, let's get into this fucking bullshit. Okafor is back from his injury. So that's something to look forward to, I guess. I decided to start Clarkson because he went off. Well, we're about to see what the buzz so we'll see if we can do it again. We got Mark Hughes, Morris. We're about to find out, along with the fans in this stadium and the people watching at home. And you can feel the excitement. Boom, Antetokounmpo already have the fucking gate. It is going to be a huge lift for your team. Derrick Rose, let's go, boy. Let's go. Let me put this defense on you.
Taking a look at the Bulls. Gibson is the four with Gasol at the five. Rose is the one with Butler is the two.
What the fuck? Why would you? Nope, get out of here.
To the inside.
Let's go, Morris.
Fellas, that two-hand monster slam was vicious.
I don't think anyone, and I mean anyone, that could have stopped him on that one.
I tell you what. So I'm trying to avoid the three-point shot as much as I can, unless it's wide open. Because we cannot make shit.
You know, guys, Taj Gibson now is six full seasons in the NBA, already 30 years old.
Oh, like what the fuck? Antetokounmpo missed that, man.
Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Fred Hoiberg. What'd you find out, DB?
The frustration was evident in his voice when I asked him about the way their season had been developing. He told me, we've been learning the hard way that anything less than a 100% effort is not going to get it done. I want to see my guys a lot hungrier than they have been. That would certainly help, gentlemen.
Thanks, Doris.
Yeah, but the thank you, Okafor.
It's critical that you contest his shots every time down the floor.
Beyond that's good enough. Boom! Told you. Let's go, Powell.
That's always a good sign.
It's a great fucking sign. This might be a blowout.
It's another look.
No, damn it.
Gasol's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Antetokounmpo, top one point guard.
That was a freebie.
Clarkson gets to Okafor.
And he was Okafor with the foul, boy.
Clearly the 76ers were the youngest team in the league last season, and with all the draft picks they
really are we fucking doing this? Okafor.
But if the youth can grow and develop.
Oh, we are fucking doing this, okay.
To give you an
we
idea
have a center who can't shoot free throws, that's good to fucking know.
Last season, Greg, Tim Duncan had more seasons played in the NBA than the entire active roster of the 76ers.
That's hard to fathom. I mean, we all know there's this youth movement going on in Philadelphia, but they still need some veterans in that locker room. Very hard for the young players to lead.
Boom.
Antetokounmpo,
boy.
First quarter for him. He's creating good opportunities and converting those that he creates.
Oh, shit. No, don't do that. Don't do that. Don't do that. Yeah, when you don't have to play LeBron James, Kevin Love, and Kyrie, it's kind of fucking much easier.
The shot's good on the assist by Butler.
Textbook, nice pass, great catch.
Both the games by Corey were fucking against Kyrie, LeBron, and Love, though, so.
And we've talked
about oh, Antetokounmpo!
And that really wasn't the case in that game for them.
There
was no hard way about it. I mean, they got their points easily on dunks and layups against the defense.
Really, we got my boy Josh Smith.
And still, I don't know that anyone can define what Giannis' position is. It's kind of still up in the air. I mean, he's played most.
He's a fucking power forward.
And thus far, maybe that could end up being the best fit.
Here's what Philadelphia is going with right now. Smith comes in for Giannis.
No, he's not draining that.
Chicago also making some changes. Joakim Noah is checked in for Gasol. Portis comes in for Taj Gibson. And Mirotic subbed in for Doug McDermott. Prior to last season, Giannis was experimenting with the point guard position for stretches during the summer league.
Well, you know, Kevin, he's just the type of guy who size and
Josh Smith, boy. That's why he's signed.
Here it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great position inside.
Yeah, just getting the ball into the post has to be option number one for them right now.
Now here's Butler.
Bitch, please.
He really had an off night against the Timberwolves. Never really got the rhythm.
Really impressed with the way Jimmy
bailout. Bitch, that's what I thought.
Someone you can build your team around.
Thiago Splitterman.
Yep. Across the board last season, won the most improved player of the year award. Really picking up his production in his fourth season.
Oh yeah, we got Marco Bellinelli
of potential in Butler before. Last season, he sustained great play and really took everything to the next level.
Now, here is Smith. He's coming off a 22-point game against Orlando.
Let's go, Smith.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this league.
Quality looks they're getting, and they're capitalizing on them, guys. They have to be happy with this start offense.
5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock.
Let's fucking go, Come on,
Here's Mirotic. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him.
Pull up. Oh my lord. Wow. New additions be killing it.
Guts right there.
Oh man. No explanation, no excuses, no hesitation, no fear. Just tremendous execution.
Hell yeah.
And your Bulgari. Talked about the intensity of this Chicago.
I feel like we're the hungriest team.
I don't give a fuck what you think about your team. The trash.
Being that famished five, especially with
wait, am I recording? Yes, I am.
There's no doubting that, Kevin. I mean, even the addition of Gasol with his two rings. The way he left things in L.A. That left him with an appetite that has him still
Welcome
back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move on. And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
They've been very good in the low post. I'm sure they'll be looking to continue that as the game wears on.
Yeah, they're showing some muscle also.
Boom, bitch. You can't talk with me. I'm Jordan Clarkson right now. Now I'm Bellinelli. Marco Bellinelli. This is so smelly. Yeah, I'm going to carry. Don't fucking know why I'm doing this.
More outside. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in.
Damn it, you bitch.
Moore's got his first points of
I'll
the night.
Take the combo. Get out of here. I'm not going to let you be point guard.
Pretty far these days. Coach Brett Brown, another former member of the Spurs staff, to be leading
post
the
up.
NBA team.
The jump hook again.
Bitch.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
It's becoming a theme in this game, Clark. They are piling up the points.
Bitch, please.
Has a wide open look. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. Well, Greg, for Brett Brown and the Spurs connection, he was an assistant in San Antonio for 7 years, was really indoctrinated by the Spurs. Dr. Business, Clark, before coming in the 76ers.
Yeah, he's got an interesting accent, too, a mix of Boston, Australian.
What the fuck? Come back down here. Don't let Austin get some above point, please.
He's good in both.
He was actually a head coach for Australia for a while in international play.
Mm-hmm.
catching up on the changes. Back him down. He's a little bitch. And it's Powell in for Bellinelli. What the fuck is this going to bounce out like that for real? Now here's Moore. Pass to McDermott. Three pointer. What the fuck, bitch? Please. The 76ers have gone 2 or 3 from the field here to open the second quarter. Here's Powell. Oh, you bet. That's his first foul. Really, Tim Hardaway Jr. Timmy. Yeah, but in this case, I think he got it right. The defender was still moving. You there. Have to get a really right. Good legal guarding position. He wasn't set. And the 76ers making a change here. Hardaway's checked in.
Oh my lord. How come everybody can make it right now?
I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass it.
Yeah, it was. So I took it. Damn! Hold up. Can we get a replay on that shit?
Just give up what you got. Freeze and stop. Cause it's as simple as to make your breathing stop. I'll body you. That's what I told y'all last year. The rappers are pussy wiping your faces a pap smear. Said I wasn't coming, but y'all
in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Kicks it to Powell. Gasol against Okafor. The fadeaway.
Yeah, that was not going in a million years.
Gibson setting the
bitch, please, don't ever fucking try that again. Bitch, you get attacking. No. Let's go. Philadelphia the other way now. They've led by as many as 11 points. Boom, pull up your bag, trash. Boom! Norman Powell, that's why I got you. That's why you're starting. You finally showing up. You finally showing up.
We've got something new up our sleeve. It should be fun.
I'm about to break this fucking pattern of losing one to winning one. Fucking shithead over here. You're gonna be who I break it on, guys.
For the brass in Chicago, signed that 5-year deal over the summer, was easily one of the most in-demand coaches available.
So he gets on the way up and two shots coming up.
Kevin, you knew the expectations were going to be high going forward, very high. But sometimes you step back before you move forward. He only shot 39% last season. Very low for a guy of his caliber. To the middle. Here's Portis. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
And we were talking about Hardaway Jr.
We're 76ers. How do we have fucking fans? Holy shit.
Himself off screens, plays with good energy and intensity. For this young man, I believe the sky is the limit.
Well, I guess we're not the Nets, so that's probably how. You know, fucking shit.
It's not my thing to compare guys to other players, but he could use a little bit of his dad's quickness and ball handling. Tim Sr. was one of the best in the league at getting his own shot.
Woo! That's not what I was going for. I was going for actual alley-oop, but okay, Morris, I see you.
Hey, this one counts, Clark. Believe me, what confidence to attempt the alley-oop to himself.
he couldn't resist on that. The adrenaline just flowing. One of the more spectacular plays.
Oh shit! Hi.
Rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try
Josh Smith.
Layups. There's no way you're gonna get back in this game.
Bulls trail by 15.
Defense. Yeah, let's go. I got people cheering.
Butler attacking.
No fucking way. Goddamn, Jimmy Butler.
That could be just what they need.
need to pick their energy
that
up.
Was pretty fun. Oh my lord.
No doubt about it, guys.
Okay, there you go. Give it to Josh Smith. Give it to him. Boom! Power, actually. They are fucking nasty with it in the paint. This whole team. Giving us a great look at that. Oh shit! The rejection by Smith. Here's Morris. Yeah, I just shot it up. It's the 2K Sports halftime show. All right then, boy. Now it's been all right. Show so far. We'll see if that changes here. Come on, Rose. Come on. Come on. And it's Marcus Morris. Then there's Jordan Clarkson. Fucking destroying their asses this game, hopefully. I'm winning, that's all I got to say. But again, I was winning the Cavaliers game too. But you know, I don't talk about it. That pissed me off so badly. I want to Kumbo. Takumbo deserves a contract. He's got seven. Aw, that's cute. Bye bye. What are you doing? 17 points per game, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. Okay. That's nothing, boy. Putting up some huge
numbers offensively. Yeah, you know, you just plug him in. He's a flat-out scoring machine.
When you plug him up, let him boy, that's the hill or Jaleel before. At getting the ball
inside. I tell you, we're taking a look at some real deficiencies defensively. I mean, they've given up 5 straight good looks in the paint.
Time called here. The Bulls decide. Antetokounmpo is a beast in it. You know what, a lot of 3-pointers. This team, the starting lineup is nice, dude. On those 3-pointers, I just felt like they I'm were happy I got Marcus Morris. You know, Greg, he's killing that small forward. But they just kept making things worse. Sometimes the harder you try, the worse it gets. And I think Doris Burke has something for us right now. Doris. Oh, put that up there. Boy. The head coach of the Chicago Bulls was going over in his huddle. The focus of their discussion was getting their offense to run through Butler. Coach stressed the importance of getting the ball in his hands as soon as possible at the start of their possession. Damn, you suck, no Rose. Can't get my defense off you.
He also told them that he wants to see multiple passes on every possession. He said that was the key to getting the best shot each time.
Damn, I should have pulled up.
Coach was not wasting any time in altering their strategy here in the second half. And Kevin,
I'll take the Kumbo, Kumbo.
Thanks, Doris.
Killing it. Killing it. Scary
Giannis could be when his jumper is hitting grade. Every year, it seems to be improving.
And last season, Kevin, he shot just under 50% from the floor, so that's a huge jump for him.
Bitch, that was luck. Really going time out on me, boy? Look at them, they both look like they got the same hairstyle. Them boys.
You know, for Giannis, it's not that he's just getting to the rim as to why his field goal percentage is up. I mean, in the last part of the season, his mid-range shooting percentage went up from 30% to over 50%. Here's
what
Philadelphia's
going with right now. What the fuck? How you gonna miss that, boy? Brewer comes in for Marcus Morris. Pull up. Hardaway is boom! That's good. Have I even missed the three yet, boy?
They've done a lot of things well today, but really, it's about what they've done on the backboard that's at the top of that.
Ante Tacumba did not even fucking touch that bitch, but okay. And Giannis is already hard to guard, but if he can reliably hurt you over the top, then a lot of nightmares will be realized in the NBA.
Incredible that he's improved as much as he has in this short amount of time.
Derrick Rose, all right, let's go.
Spirit. We know about his toughness, has fought through injuries of all kinds that might cause a lesser competitor to hang up his sneakers.
And competitor, that's the word, Kevin. I mean, he
fucking
was impossible
shit, you know.
To outcompete at the high school level, the college level.
and now in the pros. No fucking way you make that. Trying to use the
glass. You know, he just hasn't looked right to me. A bit out of sorts, if you will. Something's off with his mechanics. At least as I look at it.
Boom, that's in. Boy, why the fuck ain't my shot going?
And you know, back to D Rose for a moment. He drives the lane now as hard as he did before the injuries. It's a level of fearlessness that only a few guys possess.
Oh shit.
It's not teachable. You either have it or you don't.
Yep.
Third quarter of basketball here in just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by. Clarkson kicks to Black.
That's in. No, fuck. He blocked my ass. They're really raping me right now. That interior defense is fucking killing me.
Black grabs the board.
Good read.
And you know, back to D Rose. He grew up in a brutally dangerous neighborhood on Chicago's south side. Some of that fearlessness.
There we go. That's in, boy.
Was learned early on out of necessity. Just Mr. Reliable again here today, Kevin. I mean, they need his points, and he's producing.
Chicago calls timeout. Bulls always tough on the road, and last season different. They would end with 23 road wins on the year.
And that number was good enough for the second most in the East. Unlike shooting,
ooh,
it's very
nice
hard
deal.
For defenses to go cold, and that's why the Bulls have been so good on the road.
Oh, what? 2K? Okay, I see you then. You don't want me to fucking win this. They're doing everything they can to stop me from getting this W. Look at this. They call up so much.
I like that. A little smash mouth basketball, taking it inside.
And guys, touching back on the Bulls on the road, to illustrate how good they are on the road, last season marked the fifth straight year.
Oh my fucking gosh, I forgot they have the best fucking predictions ever. Get rejected, bitch.
Now, Antetokounmpo, 12 points for him. Inside, Teague.
Pull up there, Teague, boy. Teardropper.
Rose.
Trash.
He got it up that time, but it wouldn't fall.
That's what I thought, boy.
And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know.
Well, shit.
The 76ers leading by 20. So for Chicago right now.
We have a 20-point lead. If we fucking lose in the end of this, I'm fucking done.
It's McDermott and Gibson. A jump hook and good.
Bitch, trying to fucking stop me from doing that.
Okafor's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for Philadelphia. Pass to Portis. There's the dish to McDermott. There's a screen. Okafor with
the that, boy. That's disrespectful.
Down low, here's
Powell. Great pass to Sam. I thought he was going to dunk, but he laid it up.
On the hustle stats for the 76ers.
Boy, they're hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end. Very impressive.
Oh, shit. Team dead.
Turnovers as a result.
And also, how about the points they
fucking
got in transition?
Shit.
Or on the fast break tonight.
That's not fair. He killed Teague.
As well.
Philadelphia's gone along perfectly from three.
So they got all of everything that they wanted out of that play.
From six away.
How the fuck are you gonna miss that, Antetokounmpo? That's some bullshit. Cheating, bitch. Bitch, please, stop trying to drive on me. Oh my lord. Stop trying to drive on me, you trash.
Fourth quarter now, we're about a minute and a half in. Teague drives in. Knocked loose.
What the fuck? What the fuck? 2K? Okay, fine. Be on their side, bitch.
Yeah, a little bit of cotton mouth here. Dry spell.
Nope, no. Get that the fuck out of here, bitch. I'm not. I'm done. I'm beating 2K right now. Boom! Bitch.
Tell you what, he's not an easy guy to stop when he's got his sight on the rim.
Never has. That's what I fucking thought.
He is a determined finisher.
Did he just go chop chop there? Put that one hand. Tomahawk slam.
That's just run of the mill for him.
Oh my lord. This is ridiculous.
Skilled offensive players out there. You know, Jimmy Butler is one of those guys who had to overcome major odds just to get
you
to
guys
the
trash, both trash.
Abandoned the family when Jimmy was an infant. Mom kicked Jimmy out when he was 13. The obstacles and adversity go on and on. Yet he's made it and made it big.
Boom, bitch. Look at that. Antetokounmpo.
The Bulls have gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Rose kicks to Gasol.
No. Yeah, okay. Rose is trash, though. Let's be real. Look at that. I actually like Rose, but I'm a shit talk when I'm playing people. Oh, look at that Teague hand one.
And disappearing stroke, all with a plot.
Well, you just watched Jeff Teague. He's a natural scorer. Clark, he has also made steady.
Bitch, please. Bitch, please.
In the league, he's cut down on his turnovers as well.
No, give it that read because I'm Jeff T.
Powell, the pass to Okafor.
Antetokounmpo pushes that back. There you go, Okafor. Both homeboys are like fucking killing me, bitch.
Antetokounmpo's got 3 assists now in this one.
And he's also athletic, you know, sometimes you forget that. I mean, this guy's got the tools.
Don't know how the fuck
you forget
Teague's
is
athletic.
And
what
I
the fuck,
he's
bitch?
Developing consistency at that end of the floor.
Damn.
You know, he's
Butler
down
being a bitch.
Today, but it hasn't really translated to the scoreboard yet.
Morris outside.
Oh, yeah, Okafor is going drain
Okafor
this.
Against Gasol. Okafor in the post.
Push him back, boy.
A block shot on the way, and Gasol sends it back. 2 on the clock. Fades.
Oh my lord, I just got double rejected.
A crushing blowout. Big time.
Oh, you bitch. You bitch.
That's a gaudy win for Philadelphia.
And they could do no wrong today, Steve. That's right. This was a team performing to its Clark's fullest capability.
Yeah, and a very satisfying win for him too. A game to remember, and on the other side, definitely one.
Oh my lord, did you sit there for
3 seconds? NBA season, each contest important here tonight.
Damn it.
Win will give them 4 on the season.
And guys, when you're cracking heads against somebody 4 times over the course of a season, boy, it's a great
bitch
feeling to snatch that first
block
game.
This guy, I'm locked.
Adjustments tonight against the Bulls.
I mean, when you look at the stats, you'll see just how dominant
the
game this
fuck
was.
Are you
breaking? He was extremely efficient on offense.
Antetokounmpo fucking
really
killed people today.
All game long.
Portis, he's checked in for Dunleavy.
Dunleavy. Marco Bellinelli.
The offensive rebound. Portis.
That's fucking trash. Stop giving him penalties.
Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. No good on that one.
Boy, that's what I thought. You trash anyway.
I mean, his rebounding, I think, could also be a little higher. I mean, with his bounce, he can get in there and grab a few more.
Well, guys, once again, the 76ers finished second to last in the East. Amazingly managed to win fewer games against
that's
the
in, boy.
Before,
thanks. GG. Damn, Tim Hardaway Jr. low-key killing it right now.
As they get ready to celebrate a W.
Well, let the party start. The celebration begins, and they're going to let their guys hear it.
And no excuse there for missing that one after being freed up by a great pick.
Yeah, I agree with
I
you.
Was not trying to shoot. I was trying to lay up, but okay.
Wanted.
Fuck you,
really, dude. I like the movement and communication there.
I want the last shot, boy. I want the last shot. Contact!
And that one falls for Brooks. And both free throws good.
Dude, I'm gonna have to end up trading so many people because how hot they got.
Here's Williams, and it's
thank
good.
You,
it's
last shot. GG, 69. That's how we end the game.
What, to lead you to the right place with that pass. Money.
Boom.
So it's the 76ers winning this one easily.
I finally did it! I finally won on camera! Fuck!
But positives to take away from this win. Offensively, defensively, every aspect of the game, it all went right for him.
Damn.
Josh, congratulations on the win. What elements of how the team played will you take into your next game?
The way we was able to help each other out on the defensive end. I was able to get out in the transition and get some easy buckets. And we just got to keep playing unselfish. We got to keep sharing the basketball and limit our turnovers. And I think we'll be okay.
Josh, your team always dangerous out in transition. Thank you, guys. Back to you.
Taking over.
Folks, that's going to do it for now. For Clark Kellogg, Craig Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. Now we send you to the award-winning Ernie Johnson, who's standing by in our studio.
The 2K Sports post-game
show.
What are your thoughts, Shaq, on his game tonight?
His accuracy from the field was pretty eye-catching. I mean, if he was shooting the ball, it was going in. You rarely see a performance like this with this crazy high shooting percentage.
Wow. He was doing some serious battling with the bigs down low. He's not afraid to go hard to the rack wherever he had the chance. He doesn't care about their size. He's going in there, and he's going in there often. I think he caught him off guard with that aggressive behavior.
And that wraps things up, folks. Thanks for joining us. For Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith, Kevin Harlan, and the rest of the 2K Sports crew, I'm Ernie Johnson. Good night, everybody.
Well, shit. That's how we play. 2K. Alright. Antetokounmpo, 8 for 11. Tim Hardaway Jr., 3 for 3. 4 for 4. 3 for 3. 3 for 4. 3 for 6. 2 for 3. 2 for 3. 1 for 1. 1 for 2. 0 for 2. Brewer, 0 for 1. I didn't even know I shot with Brewer, but okay. So yeah, a great ass game. Blocks. We had a lot of blocks. Wait, that steals. Blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5. Okay, we didn't have that many blocks, or as much as I thought, but we had enough. Damn it. Shit. Well, that was fun. That we actually won. Let's see. Is there anything I gotta do? Yeah. Boys. Not what it says right there. It says now. No, it says it next time. Jeff Teague, boy, we's winning though. We's winning. We's winning. I need to talk to you. We need to have a sit down. We won. On camera at this time. Time will come. Tonight, I'll. Okay. I'm glad you understand. Thank you. Thank you. You really understand. You need to stop, you fucking bitch. I'm not talking to you because the overall will get out, or your shit will get out. Okay. Nothing important here. The hassle is fears. Hold on. Can you fucking hurry up and load? Okay, so we have Teague as a backup this year because look at this. This guy might not resign, so it's good to have Teague. Then I need to resign him. He did fucking excellent. Ray Allen's retiring, so I honestly couldn't give less of a fuck about him. Sean Williams, I signed for free agency, and he's easily fucking replaceable, and Black is just on this roster. How is his overall dipping, but his shot is going up, and everything's going up? That makes no fucking sense to me. Who's my sixth man? Well, Teagues, guess what? Nah, you can stay sixth man. You're a homeboy. Sean Williams got the fucking first week. Fucking LeBron James. Russell Westbrook got it twice in a row. Damn. team records. Al Iverson turnover. League history. No, I guess I can't look at that. Alright, well, I'm gonna end this episode here, guys. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to like, comment, subscribe, turn up your thing, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace out.